Hey, I'm Stefan from Empire. Today we're going to show you how to properly install the flanging rolls for the EMT-7R. So the first thing you want to do when you get your EMT-7R and you want to switch over to flanging rolls is you're going to take off the standard 3/8 bead rolls that come with the machine. These both can come off. And you're going to notice one thing here. So these collars, you're going to leave the top one on and the bottom one's going to come off. These collars come with the machine as well. And we're going to replace the bottom one with our threaded spacing collar. This is going to go on the bottom, and this is your adjustment for the bottom roll, for the position of the bottom roll. If you come around to this side here, you'll see the locking handle. We loosen the locking handle for the lower shaft. If this shaft is positioned further forward, we want to position this shaft all the way to the back, against the back of the machine here, and then lock it down in place. Then the adjustment comes from the threaded spacing collar. So next we're going to put on the bottom roll, is the one with the large shoulder. And we're just going to install this nut just loosely for now, because we want to make some adjustments. And you take the top roll, and this one has a slight taper. The taper is going to go towards, face towards the back of the machine. So it faces up that way. And put the roll nut on. This one you can lock down and tighten it on. This one's not going to change. But this bottom roll, this is where we want to make sure we get this set up correctly. So typically for flanging, you want the space between the back shoulder of the lower roll and the top roll to be about the thickness of your material. So if you're setting up for 16 gauge stainless, you obviously want to have more space. You adjust this roll back so that you can have a little more space. If you are doing thinner material, you're going to want to bring this a lot closer. So if you're doing like 28 gauge, 26 gauge, etc. So that's why the spacing collar is there, for thin material, thick material, and fine controlled positioning. So then we lock that one down. The last thing you want to do is properly set your back gauge. This is what's going to set the height of your flange. So when we loosen the back gauge, we're going to slide this forwards till you're just about 1/8 away from the back of the shoulder of the lower roll, and lock that one down. And that's what's going to give you your positioning for the back gauge and your material to get that 1/2-inch flange. So one unique thing about our EMT-7R and how it does flanging with this tooling is that your pipe stays in the full horizontal position. It does not tip up to make a right angle flange. It stays in this horizontal position. The back shoulder is where you hook your material on top of in order to start forming, and you'll bring down the upper roll to touch the material from here. And this is how you'd start. You'd start by pinching the material, and that distance from the back gauge to where this point is essentially is the height of your shoulder of your flange. So when you get to this sort of finished point of forming your flange, you're gonna wanna lift up on the part a little bit to try to get it to a nice 90 degrees. If you leave it flat down against the back edge, it might be a little bit under. So just with a little bit of upward pressure, you can get that flange to be nice and straight. Just like that. Once you've formed your flange with this tooling, you can inspect this and you're going to have just a slight little cup in that material, because the way we form horizontally and it has to stretch around that back shoulder. The ideal situation is that this is as flat as possible, and the way you can adjust that is with that threaded spacing collar. So if you're feeling like it's getting too cupped and you need to tighten that up, you adjust the spacing collar to shorten up the gap between the top roll and the bottom roll, and that should try to flatten out that flange a little bit more. So now you've seen how to install the right angle flange rolls for the EMT-7R. Check out our other videos up here for other roll installation videos or other demos. And check out the links in the description for our website, and give us a call if you have any questions.